Hi, my name is Mark Bailey. I'm an application engineer here at Agilent Technologies. Today I'd like to show you some features of the 33500B, the new series of waveform generators. These generators are LXI compliant. What that means is they have a LAN connection on the back. So we have USB, we have LAN, and we have GPIB connections. And with the LAN, there's a built-in web server built into the 33500B, and I'm going to show you how that the advantages of having that web server built in. So now I have my 33500B generator connected directly to my laptop via a LAN cable. Nothing going on in between, just the two directly coupled. The 33500B has a unique IP address, which I've gotten. I'm going to go ahead and put that into my web browser. And when I do, up pops this screen, which is a welcome screen for the 33522B. So now I'm connected to the generator and I'm talking to it. I'm going to go to the control screen. Now, when I get to the control screen, it gives me control over waveforms, modulation, sweep, burst, even output, turning it on and off and changing loads and so forth. So let's go back to waveform. Right now I'm in a default mode, which is a 1 kilohertz sine wave. I'm going to turn that into a ramp wave. I'm going to make the frequency, instead of one kilohertz, I'm going to turn it into 2 kilohertz. And I'm going to increase the amplitude a little bit. Right now it's 100 millivolts. I'm going to actually turn it into 200 millivolts, and I'm going to change the symmetry from 100%. I'm going to make that about, let's say 30%. Okay, so very easy to change all this stuff. I'm going to go ahead and apply that waveform, and what you'll see on the scope is that when I did that, it changed. Okay, so remember we could change waveforms, but we could also change modulation, sweep, burst, and so forth. Let's go to modulation. I'm going to go ahead and turn modulation on. I'm going to select AM modulation. I want an internal source. I'm going to make the depth, let's make that 80% depth, and the AM frequency of 100 hertz. Okay, so let me go ahead and apply that, and you'll see on the scope when I apply it that it goes into AM mode. Okay, so I hope you've seen that you can do all kinds of control, and again, I'm just doing this over LAN directly to my instrument. One final thing I want to point out is the command monitor. So when I click on command monitor, it comes up with a list in SCIPI of all the different commands I've made. SCIPI stands for Standard Commands for Programmable Instrumentation, and that's what people use when they program these instruments. So you can imagine that you could cut and paste this information here. Okay, so I hope you've seen some of the advantages that are built into the 33500B or any of our LXIC instruments. The fact that it's got a built-in web browser, with the ability to control the instrument directly via LAN. It can be right next door, like I'm showing here. It can be off in the lab and you're in your office. It can be halfway around the world. There's some real advantages to using LAN with the LXIC instruments. Thanks, I hope this has been useful. Talk to you later, bye.